Hello and welcome. I'm very pleased to introduce to you José Antonio López Guerrero, Head of the Laboratory of Molecular Biology and Scientific Director of the Biobank in IVO in Valencia. He's going to present to you today the MPD breast cancer recurrence risk assay that was developed and validated by IVO and supported by Dovis and HG Molecular. This presentation is from the UK Biomarkers Congress in 2021.
Good afternoon, everyone. I would like to thank the organizers for the presentation, and also I would like to thank HDG for the opportunity to be here and present our work on breast cancer recurrent risk classification using the HDG technology. These are our disclosures. We have an agreement with HDG in order to develop new biomarkers for being used in clinical routine. And we have developed MammaPrET that I will call it has MPD, that has been developed by our institution, the Fundación Instituto Valenciano de Oncología, also Fundación Pública Andaluza, de Progreso y Salud, and the Consorcio Centro de Investigación Biomédica en Red. All these three institutions came from Spain. This is the agenda or the topics in which I'm going to present you. It's about the breast cancer stratification, the importance of that, how we have developed MPD, and also we will speak about absolute intrinsic molecular classification using data from HDG. Well, I can imagine that, I don't know if you are aware about that, but breast cancer is from the molecular point of view, is an heterogeneous disease. We know that at least there are four molecular subtypes that are divided in depending on the expression of three biomarkers, the estrogen receptor, progesterone receptor, and also the HER2, the receptor, epidermal growth factor receptor 2. And this expression classifies breast cancer in these four molecular subtypes. Luminal cases that mainly express estrogen and progesterone receptors, HER2 cases that mainly express or have amplified HER2 gene, and the triple negative cases that they do not express any of these three biomarkers. What is important of this classification, this classification provides diagnostic and also prognostic information. So those triple negative constitutes the cases with a worse prognosis, and this classification also provides a therapeutic approach. They also provide a predictive information. So luminal cases are treated with endocrine therapy, HER2 cases are treated with a monoclonal antibody anti-HER2, and triple negative cases are treated with chemotherapy. Well, it's very well known that it has been put into attention the interest from the clinical point of view to try to characterize breast cancer from the molecular point of view. And there are many platforms that can be outlined in this table that has are focused in characterizing luminal cases, early stage breast cancer luminal cases, with the aim of identifying patients with a high probability of recurrence in a period of 5 years. This test, as you can see here, are based on different technologies. They are already optimized for being working on paraffin material tissue, and all of them provides prognostic information. The two main technologies or platforms that are being used in the clinical routine are MammaPrint and Oncotype, and these platforms are, at least in Spain, are very well established in the clinical routine. the problem of this, not the problem, the limitation of these technologies is that if we compare the two technologies, the agreement between them is around 70% in most of the cases. The distribution of the risk groups are also different between these two approaches. For instance, MammaPrint classify in a higher proportion patients with higher risk of recurrence, and it is leading a potential overtreatment because patients that have been classified as high risk, they are treated with chemotherapy. And from the biological point of view, they are the genes that define the different genetic profiles. Not in any case are the same genes, but in some way they are representing similar characteristics. Well, there are two studies, two clinical studies that demonstrated the clinical utility of these two tests. This is the MINDAC trial. The MINDAC trial used the MammaPrint platform to classify patients in high and low risk. And this is the design of the clinical trial. In that case, those patients classified as high risk by genomic profiles and also high risk from the clinical pathological point of view were treated with chemotherapy. Those cases classified as low risk and with a low risk from the clinical pathological point of view were treated with endocrine therapy, and the discordant cases, between the genomic platform and also the clinical pathological analysis, were randomized one by one in treating with chemotherapy. And the results of this trial conclude that only patients classified as high risk using the genomic platform were benefited by chemotherapy. This is one of the points. The other platform is Oncotype. Oncotype, the clinical trial that demonstrated the clinical utility of this platform was the Tylorex. Tylorex was published in a couple of years ago in New England Journal of Medicine, and in that case, the classification score of the Oncotype classified patients in three cohorts. The low risk, that were treated only with hormone therapy, the high risk treated with chemotherapy, and the intermediate risk that were also splitted into arms, one treated with chemotherapy and the other one with chemotherapy. The conclusions of the clinical trial were that only patients also classified as high risk by Oncotype were benefited for chemotherapy. And in those cases, and those women with 50 years or younger classified as intermediate risk, they also were benefited for chemotherapy. So in that context, we propose a study to SDG in order to define and validate an expression profile for the risk classification of breast cancer using the SDG technology. And this is one agreement that what we established in 4 years ago, and this is the aim of the study. Develop and validate a recurrence risk group using the SDG EDGESEC technology, and also using one of the panels that SDG have in its portfolio. This is the Oncology Biomarker Panel, which is a panel of 2,560 genes. And this is the inclusion criteria of the cases that we analyzed. All the criteria meet the characteristics of patients that has been tested with MammaPrint and Oncotype. And all these cases, we asked for samples to different biobanks in different hospitals in Spain. We provide samples that were already tested with MammaPrint and Oncotype. The Hospital Universitario Ramón y Cajal provide cases tested with MammaPrint. Hospital del Mar in Barcelona provide test samples from patients tested with Oncotype. And also we require the support of the Valencian network of biobanks for providing more samples tested with MammaPrint and Oncotype. At the end, this is the workflow of the analysis. We started with the paraffin MVD material, and we hybridized the paraffin, and we hybridized in this system with the proofs of the oncology biomarker panel. This is the characteristics of the OBP panel. And we performed the library for sequencing, and we sequence in a NextSeq 550. Optimally, we were able to analyze all the cases. Well, not all the cases. We are able to provide the results in 2 days and a half. I mean, we are optimized the procedures in which we were. We prepared libraries for 96 cases, and in 2 days and a half, we were able to get the results, the result of sequencing. And this is the one of the advantages of the STG technology is the input of material is very low. We work with five thin sections of paraffin MVD material with a minimum area of 15 millimeters squared. And that's it. This is an example that you can see how we work in the lab. And this is the series that we analyze for developing the MPD test. We have analyzed, we included in the study more than 800 samples. From these samples, only 4.5% of samples were not able to be tested by STG technology because the different reasons. And for the developing of the MPD, we used 606 samples classified in these cohorts. Around 50% were tested by MammaPrint, and the other 50% were tested with Oncotype, with the different levels of classification provided by the different genomic platforms. At the end, and we use a retrospective series of 178 cases for validating the MPD test. At the end, from these 178 cases, we use 144, for which we had a complete clinical information for providing the results. Well, we perform a different analysis of reproducibility. For each run of sequencing, we introduce three replicates of RNA, and this is the correlation of the replicates in all the cases were highly reproducible. And this is the training set from which we develop MPD. We used taking all the data from the OBP panel, from the expression level of the whole OBP panel genes, and we apply different algorithms and some tools of artificial intelligence and deep learning machine. And we obtain different predictors with a high level of accuracy in order to classify patients in high and low risk. At the end, we decided to work with this algorithm because this algorithm was obtained taking the results from the two platforms. And this is more or less the expected results. The results is the accuracy of the test is higher than 80%, considering only cases classified by Oncotype, cases classified by MammaPrint, and cases classified by both platforms. So the accuracy was very, very high. And this is another view of this classification. This blue line is the median of our score. This is not a cutoff. This is just a median in which the higher below the median are represented the low risk cases that match very well with the low risk cases from mama print and Oncotype, for instance. The cases upper the blue line corresponds to the high risk cases, which also corresponds to high risk classified by mama print and Oncotype, and this is the intermediate risk cases from women with 50 years and younger. At the end, this is we have developed we have reduced the signature in a total of 56 genes that in some way each gene is participating in the algorithm that in the classifier. All these genes in some way using the G-profile tool, all these genes are involved in the insulin receptor signaling cascade and insulin growth factor receptor 1 and the PIK3A pathway, in a pathway of proliferation, and also in pathways that are involved in breast pathology. Well, in order to validate this algorithm, that we did is was to analyze a series of 144 retrospective cases. These series, they were not tested by mama print and Oncotype. This is a naive series. And these series have more than 10 years of follow-up. From these 144, there were 15 cases with local recurrence and distant metastasis. And this is the main characteristics of the series. All these series met the same characteristics of the training set, and this is the results of the applying the MPD predictor and classifier to this series. That all cases, not all cases, those cases that are classified as high risk at the end have the worst prognosis. So in some way we have validated that. In clinically validated our predictor. Well, this is the metrics of the MPD. The MPD at the end is that we have obtained a balanced accuracy of more than 80%. If we take into account that the concordance between mama print and Oncotype by themselves don't achieve the 70%, we are getting, we are improving a bit this performance. This is the CAP analysis, the concordance with a CAP of 0.5, the specificity at 90%, and a negative predictive value of more than 90%. And this is the correlation between replicates. We perform more than 100 replicates between different experiments, and also be different intra and inter experiment, and the correlation was always very, very high. This is the other point that I would like to highlight is the importance of the molecular classification of the absolute intrinsic molecular subtyping. This is very important. Why is important the classification of breast cancer? This is because it provides diagnosis and prognostic information, as I already told you at the beginning of the talk. There are other platforms like PAM50 that classify breast cancer in five subtypes, luminal, A, B, normal-like, HER2, and basal, or triple negative. And this PAM50 is based on the technology of nCounter, the nanostring, and this is based on the expression of 50 genes. There is an algorithm which is called IMS that is obtained the absolute intrinsic molecular classification. This algorithm provides also which is free. It is free. We can. And it works in R framework. This This IMS is based on the spectrum analysis of 151 genes, taking into account whole transcriptome, and is less dependent of the technology used. And it has been established, the agreement of applying this algorithm with the PAM50 is around 70%, 77%. Well, what we have analyzed is that this algorithm can be also applied with the data from HTG. The OBP panel, for instance, has 89 genes that are already included in the 150 genes that defines the IMS algorithm. And the OBP panel comprising also the 41 of the 100 rules in order to make a decision regarding the breast cancer classification. What we did was to apply the IMS subtyping using the Metabrick dataset, and you can see here that there is practically no difference between applying the IMS classifier using all the 150 genes of the algorithm classifying the breast cancer cases, and using the genes that are included in the OBP panel of HTG. At the end, what we did was to make a correlation study using all these of the HTG genes and the IMC all genes, and the concordance is the precision is around 90% with a kappa coefficient of 82%, which is very 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 high. So that means the IMS algorithm applied with the HTG genes from the OBP panel could be also a very good tool for classifying patients or for the subtyping of breast cancer cases. The idea that that we are trying to do is to implement all these two algorithms within the Reveal software, that is the software that HTG provides to the users. The idea, they have already some of the panels and some signatures already defined in the Reveal framework. And the idea in the case of breast cancer is to work with the HTG oncology biomarker panel, the expression levels obtained from that genes to be run or to be analyzed by the MPD algorithm and also the IMS algorithm in order to provide information about the recurrence risk classifier and molecular subtyping. We think that point is could be very useful for the different users, at least from the clinical point of view. And that's all. I would like to thank all the people involved from HTG, the different partners that have participated in the development of MPD, and that's all.